So when Mukunda inquired, did you inquire from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu this question? He said, yes, but he has said after your 3,000 of repeated birth, he will be allowed. So he began to dance. Oh, then I will be allowed someday. Never mind 3,000 births. So when this was informed to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that he is dancing now because he will allow him to come in after 3,000 of birth, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very pleased and asked him to bring him immediately. So if we want to actually learn, that's like, that must be ekanishtha. Bhajanti mam ananya bhava. That is the quality. If you want to know Krishna, it is very easy. Don't divert your attention to anything. I worship this demigod, I worship that demigod. Then your knowledge is gone. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Tamastastha hitajnana jajante anna devata. Anna devata, other demigods. Devata is Krishna. But others, they are demigods. Ekola Ishwar Krishna are sabhritta. Jare jaiche nachaye se toiche kare nritta. God is one, Krishna. Ekamiva dityam. All others, they are servants. This is our conclusion, this is Shastric concept. Eka Brahma dityam. Brahma cannot be two. Parabrahma. Parabrahma. Paramam bhavan. Therefore, Arjuna has addressed him as bhavan, yourself. Not that you have got many competitors. Just like we find nowadays, in one street another god, in another street another city, there are so many gods. No, God is one, ekamaiva aditya. And that is Krishna. Krishnastu Bhagavan Sam. So this is Krishna consciousness. So if we want to learn about Krishna, then we have to follow the path of Mahajan, great personality, just like Brahma is presenting, Brahma Sanghita, describing. Vyasa is presenting Srimad Bhagavatam. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Bhagavan himself is describing himself in the Bhagavad Gita. So what is the difficulty to understand Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavan? We don't find any difficulty. Where is the difficulty? The Mahajan is there, the Shastra is there, the Guru is there, the Ved is there. And why should he make research after God? What is this nonsense? Everything is there. Vedaishta sarvai ahamiva vedam. The purpose of Veda is to know Krishna. Janmadasya jataha. Athata brahma jignasa. To inquire about Brahma. Brahma. There is no need of searching out God. You can simply try to digest whatever is already there. The Bhagavad Gita is there. All the acharyas, they have accepted. They have written commentation on Bhagavad Gita with reference to the Vedic knowledge. The absolute Krishnastu Bhagavan Sam is accepted everywhere by all acharyas. Why you are searching after God? I do not know. So, this Bhagavad Gita and this Brahma Sanghita in the description is about Krishna and his abode. Advaita yachyate anadi ananta rupam adyam purana purusam navajovananya. Vedeshu durlabaya durlabha atma bhakto govindamadi purusam tamanaya. Advaita. Advaita yachyate anadi ananta rupam. He has got ananta rupam. There is no limit. He has got so many. Because in each and every Brahmanda, there is Krishna avatar. Krishna avatar, just like in this Brahmanda, there was Krishna avatar 5,000 years ago. Similarly, Krishna avatar is going on. Just like the same example as I have given you many times, that the sun planet is there in the sky, but sun is visible when he is in our front. Otherwise, sun is there. Similarly, Krishna is always there. But when he descends, incarnates, he becomes visible to us, exactly like the sun. At the present moment, it is night, sun is not visible. But in due course of time, say after 8 hours or 10 hours, in the morning the sun will be visible. Similarly, there is scheduled time when Krishna becomes visible on this planet, on this universe. And there are innumerable universes. That is called Nityalila. Nityalila means eternal pastime. Krishna is born as Devaki Nandan. Immediately he begins to grow. But that birth is taking another planet, another universe. Just like 6:30 sun sign, it is now visible on this planet or on this city. But again, 6:30 again in another city, 6:30 in another city, 6:30 another city. It is not very difficult to understand that 6:30 is continue, that 7:30 is continue, that 8:30 is continue. Every minute and second is continue. Simply you have to know where it is. You immediately try to know by phoning the other city, other on the other country. You will know that this 6:30 or 7:30 or 12:30 or the setup or rising of the sun is continually going on, here or there. Similarly, Krishna's appearance, Krishna's pastimes, everything is continually going on. Sometimes in this universe something is in another universe, sometimes another universe. In this way it is going on. Therefore, Krishna's lila is called Nitya lila. Nitya lila. Eternal. It is not that for the time being Krishna appeared. That's Nitya lila we have seen within this planet, Krishna. That will come again. Just like we saw the sun in the daytime. Now it is not visible. But in due course of time, again we shall see. Next morning we shall see sun. Similarly, we shall see again Krishna. And that rotation takes place according to Vedic calculation after 43 crores of years. That is the explanation we get from Vedic Shastra. So Krishna's lila, it is not an invented. We are worshipping Krishna as something imaginary, some artistic picture. No, it is Nitya lila. Krishna is fact. Govindam Adi Purusham. He is Adi. Advaita Chuta Adyam Purana Purusham. Purana Purusham. The oldest man. Purana means oldest. Oldest. Purana Purusham. Purusham means person. Navajovanancha. But whenever you see Krishna, he is just a perfect young boy. Navajovanancha. You will never see Krishna's picture as he has become old. He has grown some big beard and no. Krishna you'll never see. Krishna is just like a 20-year-old young boy. Navajovanancha. Vedeshu durlava, adurlava atma bhakto. He is not to be found in the Vedas. There is, but we miss. In the Rig Veda, in the Atharva Veda, Krishna is there. Vedeshu durlava, but the ordinary man cannot find. Just like the people, they are reading Bhagavad Gita, but they do not understand this. There are so many people, they are very proud of reading Bhagavad Gita daily. But they do not understand Krishna. The only thing is that missing Krishna. Except Krishna, all rubbish things they are talking. This is their vision. Because Vedeshu durlava. For the rubbish person, rascal person, Krishna is durlava. Adurlava atma bhakto. But Krishna is available. Krishna has to be seen from the Krishna's devotee, not from others. Therefore Krishna said to Arjuna that I am again explaining to you this Bhagavad Gita because bhaktosi, priyosi, rasam etat uttamam. There is a very nice mystery in this Bhagavad Gita and that will be understood by you because you are my devotee, you are my very dear. So, in order to understand Krishna, one has to first of all become a great devotee, dear friend of Krishna. Then you can understand. Otherwise, Vedesu Dullavadu Lavapavakto. So, this Brahma Sanghita describes about Krishna. Brahma is Mahajana. I have already told you. Mahajana Jena Gatasapantha. So, in this Shastra, 12 Mahajans are accepted. Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kumara, Kapila, Manu, Prahlada, Janaka, Bhishma, Bali, Vaiya, Sakhi, Bayam. This was explained by Jamraj to his servant that these are Mahajan. Who? Sambhu, Brahma, Sambhu, Narada, and Sambhu, Lord Shiva. Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kumara, the Kumaras, four Kumaras, Kapila, Kapile, Lord Kapil, Mano, Sambhu, Mano. And the Bhagavad Gita accepted this.